What's good, everybody? It's your boy Uncle Sam's Reject here with some more Fight Night Champion Legacy Mode. Remember the last couple episodes, you know, we kept up our undefeated streak, winning our fifth fight in a row, and we knocked out Sonny Liston, a boxing legend, and we moved all the way up to rank 29 on the contender list for a title. Slowly moving our way up, and you look at our legacy rating, we officially moved up from prospect to club fighter. And also, I got some very great news. Let's go ahead and look at our messages. And this is from our manager. Keep doing what you're doing, and we'll keep getting these sponsor deals. They want you to wear some of their gear next fight or something. It's not a great deal, but as long as you don't change your gear, it'll be easy money. Here's the contract. So, only thing we have to do is wear a robe of theirs for one fight, and we get an easy $1,000. We can make that happen. Now that we changed our gear up, you know what I mean, locked in for an easy $1,000, it's time for us to schedule our next fight. Now, the next fight for us to take here is number 26 ranked Barnabas Hill. He's 31-4 with 17 knockouts, but he's only 1-4 in his last fights. It's a 10-round bout, you know what I'm saying, fighting in Manila once again, and it's a purse of almost 20,000 racks. So, I think we're going to go ahead and take this one. I'm saying, even though we got our change up a little bit here, we almost got 20 stacks. We're going to train in Detroit once again. We got some, you know what I mean, a real good outcome when we did that. All right, man, it's fight night. We're ready to go, but first, let's see what our fight challenges are. All right, so they want us to win with a punch accuracy above 43, knock out our opponent by the fourth round, and also knock them down by the fourth round. So, you know what I mean, I feel like we should get at least one of those last two. The puncher accuracy, you know, I'm a headhunter, and, you know, sometimes I don't punch at the highest percentage, but we still walk away with the victory most of the time. So, let's get into this shit. All right, man, we're back at the Metro Manila Arena for our second straight fight.
To the Metro Manila Arena here in the Philippines.
You see the tail of the tape, we're younger, got a way further reach, and we're taller. You see what your boy's looking like there, 5 wins, 3 KOs, out of Philly, ready to put in this work. In our competition, Barnabas Hill out of Cuba, he's got a pretty impressive record, man, and he has some power, so we got to be careful, but I think we'll be all right. All right, man, here we go. Got
to
get this victory.
Okay,
caught him with the uppercut early. It's a longer fight than we're really used to, so you know what I'm saying? We gotta try to preserve some of the stamina. 10-round fight. Used to only fight in 6 so far early in my career. This dude is really being the aggressor. Gotta keep our distance. You know what I mean? We do have the longer reach. And this dude wants to get inside, so every time he comes inside, we gotta meet him with a jab or a straight. He's actually making me fight. I'm actually feeling kind of uncomfortable here early. No fighters really come inside of me like that. Let's go.
You were training a fighter.
Ooh, I missed the straight. That was a big one. That one would have hurt.
When you were training him in the build up to that,
so he's trying to work my body here. Trying to chop down the tree. Definitely can't let that happen, man, because once you work the body, you can't get the hands up. You can't really move as much. There we go. We're connecting at a high volume right now. As we both catch each other there, I catch him with another uppercut.
The other
one
is to step up and get sort of in.
Oh, yeah, you don't want to keep trading punches. Ooh, yes, sir. Eat both those uppercuts.
He takes a shot.
Doing a great job here of keeping him back up off us. Sorry, he caught me there. Hands were down. Ooh, yes, sir. Nice counter. Way to get your head out the way. All right, throwing a little bit too many punches. There we go. Good counter. Wasn't as electrifying as I would have hoped. Nice little jab there. Ooh, he got out of the way. That one caught me good. But I work to the body and give him an uppercut.
And you see what he can do when he sends that right.
Yes, sir. Way to get out of the way of that one. That was trouble. Ooh, he caught me with a couple there. I come back with a straight of my own. He hurt me a little bit on that one. Oh, yeah. This is definitely my round easily. Let's get it. All right, man, so we get 7% of our recovery of our stamina back. We're sitting at 89, he's at 90, so we're pretty even. Excuse me. Let's get into the second round.
Here we go.
We come out, attacking with the jab. If he wants to come inside, he's going to have to earn it. He's going to have to eat a few if he wants to come inside.
on to get one. He comes back with a right
hand. He's really coming at me, man, this round. Trying to work my body there. Got to keep my guard up. Catch him with a nice straight there. He gets one uppercut, but I leave myself wide open. I need to back him up. He's too close. He catches me with one there as I try to back him up. Oh, yeah. Let's go, baby. Let's see if we can survive this. Or if we can knock him down here early in the second round. He clinches me and he survives. But definitely looking good here. Oh, we get through his guard there with that straight. Oh, yeah, nice counter.
Keeps his hands up defensively, protecting the head.
Like I said, man, he wants to come inside. He's going to get these two streaks. I mean, his jab in his streak.
And coming
he caught me there.
Halfway mark of this 3-minute round.
Oh yeah, eat that. Oh yeah, we hurt him again. He's stunned again. Let's see if we can get him down to the canvas. He clinches me. Come on, get loose.
He could go down at any moment.
All right, I'm not going to waste my energy there. It's not that hurt. But it's still nice points for us.
I don't know what else could help him right now.
Oh, he got out of the way of that uppercut smartly, but we come back and catch him with the straight. Whew. We both catch each other with hooks there. He works my body a little bit, but it shouldn't have been. Oh, yeah. He left himself too open for me not to really take advantage of that fully. Once again, he's got me backed up in a corner. Let me see if I can get him backed up here. Oh, I missed that straight. I needed that one. That one would have hurt. 15 seconds left in this round. 10 rather, now. And we're definitely connecting at a high rate. He's trying to close the distance a little bit at the end of the round, but I definitely think that we still got that one.
And they come to the end of the
round. All right, 8% of our stamina back here. He threw a lot of punches and we countered him for the most part. He's at 84, I'm at 80, so we're still in good shape. But with us being heavyweights, man, I need to end this fight before the 6. We're not really trained up enough to go past 6, man. It gets a little boring after that. Double uppercut there. He ate both of them. Ooh, he caught me with something serious. Now it's my turn to survive. That was a hard left straight there. I give him that. We're not moving our head. Looks like we might be going down. Come on. He gets the knockdown there. So unless we can come back and knock him down, we pretty much lost this round.
You get lazy with your jab, you get sent to the canvas.
I'm good, ref. So this is my first time. I believe this is my first time touching the canvas in my career. I could be wrong, but it's still early on, so it's not like I'm 30 fights in. You know what I mean? I still got some flaws and such myself. But one thing I don't do well when I stun my opponent is we don't really go for the kill well enough, I'd say. A lot of these people have some good stun defense, and a lot of times we struggle with finishing up and getting a knockdown. We get through the guard there, though.
Mr. Showtime's putting forth that hard work he did in training camp there, landing a crisp combination.
Come on. We're hurting him with our punches. So he's semi-stunned. He's going to protect himself there, so we're going to chill. We're not going to waste too much stamina trying to go for a knockdown. But he's going to keep leaving himself open. If he wants to keep punching, throw the punches he's throwing, he's going to eventually leave himself open. Oh, we both catch each other there with some punches. He's still hurting a little bit. He's not all the way good yet. We work his body a little bit. 40 seconds left in the round. Damn, I want my knockdown so I can win this round. If I knock him down as well, this round is mine.
All right,
let me chill out. Use a little bit too much energy here.
He's
trying to clinch. All right, let me back up. Definitely frustrating. He's fighting super scared.
Right in front of a guy and make the guy miss.
Damn.
At least he could do that.
We use a lot of energy. Hopefully we can get some of that back. Last 3 seconds here in the round. See if we can get a punch in. We catch each other there. So I definitely lost that round getting knocked down. It's all good. Left myself a little open and I got caught slipping.
Time to take a look at Teddy's.
So you see here I won the first 2 rounds, lost the last one because I'm knocked down. I would have won that one as well. Nice little counter there. He's trying to clinch already. Ooh, I'm missing punches I need to connect with.
This is not amateur boxing, professional boxing. The power punches.
Come on, man, keep making him eat these jabs.
More than he hurts you. They count for more.
Mr.
Yes, sir. 1-2. Classic combo.
Being knocked down in the last round. But with just 60 seconds between rounds, Teddy, how much could really happen? How much
when it got in the way of that one. That was a little nice little haymaker.
First of all, you hit him with that sponge. Some cold water on top.
Don't let him get in too close. Back him up.
Invigorate him a little bit. You know, get his senses back a little bit. And you have to.
Three is trying to work my body again.
Once he calms down, once you physically get him back on track.
Damn.
To see if he's okay. And then
yes, sir. That's a good little punch.
Why he got dropped to begin with.
Good work to
eat that. Let's go.
Mr. Showtime. Plus, he landed that.
As long as we can stay off of the canvas, we're going to win these rounds. We're connecting at a way better percentage. Countering a lot. He's missing a lot of punches, actually. Yes, sir. He's leaving himself open a lot. I'm just waiting to throw the power punch. Just tagging right now. Getting my points. There he is, hitting my body twice. Those definitely hurt. Foot off the gas a little bit this round, because I don't think I'm going to get the knockdown. We kept our head moving, because that could have been scary. As we catch him on another straight, we finally protect the body there.
Mr. Showtime.
Got the way. 30 seconds left in this round. Keeping my distance. A little 1-2 again. So we're scoring at a high rate. That's for sure. Both defensively and offensively. Catch him with an uppercut there. Another straight.
A little give and take, and here comes the
I definitely think he can punch. He might punch himself out of this fight, and I'll eventually get the knockout. But if we got to go to the scorecards, I need to be prepared for that, too. As we get 11% back of our stamina, let's see where we're sitting at now. Only 67%, him 73. That's one thing about fighting with these heavyweights, man. They're not built to go these long distance fights, man. So got to be careful because I'm low on stamina. Might take this round off a little bit. Let him punch himself tired. Went off defense. Throw a punch here and there. Just like so. No need to throw a bunch of punches. All he's doing is hitting my guard right now. Eat that. Ooh, he caught me there, though. Caught me slipping there. Hurt me a little bit. Getting punched in the gut definitely doesn't feel good. You can tell by my health every time he connects.
And now he's
definitely trying to work the body. I need to be prepared for that. Oh, he gets through the guard there with an uppercut. And I come back and do the same. Back off me, bruh. Oh, man. He left himself really, really exposed, and I did not take advantage there.
His opponent was able to get out of the way.
Just trying to fight smart this round, keep our stamina. Left myself open, he made me pay. Damn, why is my stamina so low? I'm not even throwing as many punches as him. Caught his dumb ass. Let's go. Work his ass. Come on, man. You gotta finish. That's what I'm talking about. We gotta be able to finish when we stun our opponent. That's what can't happen. We can't keep letting this dude survive. All right, 45 seconds left in this round. We catch him again, man. Let's go. Come on, man. Get through this guard. This shit weak. Damn, he survives once again. And we got to be careful so we don't get stunned ourselves. Caught his ass again, man. So this round is definitely ours. But we just not finishing the job, man.
Teddy, it just feels like one of those
definitely frustrating when we can't finish the job. We stunned him three times in that round, and he's still left standing. But you know what I mean? We're even on stamina now, taking a round off, fighting a little smarter. So that's probably what we're going to have to keep doing to get this W.
50 of them, 60 of them. In other words, he's not worried how he's going
to. All right, round six, man. Let's just do more of the same. Because we were definitely scoring high on that round. So let him punch himself silly. Nice little pop shots every now and then. Good counters. Well, he caught me there. Head didn't move the way I wanted it to. Good uppercut. You see, he's hurting. He's got to wait to catch him. Because he's definitely leaving himself wide open. Nice uppercut. I felt that. I hit him with a double uppercut there. Missed it straight just out of my range.
Yeah, it's a reckless aggression.
Let him punch himself soon. Damn, I missed another opportunity.
Something's going to come in between.
Good straight there. Work the body a little bit. Ooh, that one didn't connect the way I wanted it to. All right, we need to chill a little bit. I think we got this round one already. Just straight, just like that. He knows he's losing. He knows he has to go for a knockout. So we need to just let him punch himself loose. And then hopefully we catch him with something good. And send his ass on his back pockets. Yeah, keep thinking shit's sweet. Ooh, he blocked the uppercut. Oh, yeah, we hurt him again, man. He's got to go down here. Come on, man. Still to the canvas. Let's go. That's what I'm talking about, man. See me punching through that weak-ass guard. He's hurting. Came through the elbow, a little UFC there. Probably a little illegal, but, you know, ref didn't see it. At a bad distance, no man's land. Don't get up. All right, he got up, man. So we both have scored a knockdown here in this fight. But I think I can end it here soon. Mr. Showtime scoring with that. I think we can end it here soon. Leaving himself wide open. Eating uppercuts. Damn, man. He had one more punch and he was going down. And now we got a fight. He fires back. Yes, sir. He knows he needs a knockout to win. All right, man. Leaving myself susceptible there. All right, that's our round. We definitely won that one. Easily, excuse me. I don't know why I say easy like that. But we got 11% back. We actually have more stamina. That's what I'm doing. Just got to let dude punch himself tired. No need to win all 10 rounds if you don't need to. Come right out with a straight. We both catch each other there. Now he wants to clinch. He's feeling it a little bit. Eat that, motherfucker. Let's go. Come on, baby. Finish it. Finish it. Finish it. Punch through that weak-ass guard. Finish it. Ah. Ooh. I'm tired there a little bit. Ooh. I missed him, so let me chill, because I definitely felt that punch up. A lot more than I thought. Ooh, just out of my range there.
A little something for his opponent after getting tagged.
Oh, yeah. He's not going to last too much longer. Believe that. We both catch each other there. All right, man. Minute 45 left in this round. All right, he's still trying to work the body, and I'm definitely feeling those punches. Let me get out of the way, get my composure a little bit. Breathing a little heavy with my mouth open here. Ooh, left myself wide open. He didn't take advantage, but I did there. Ah, not on that one, though. Hill's doing a poor job. There's no other way to really uppercuts getting through the guard. Let's go. Stay committed to being a counterpuncher. But in the meantime, the fight is getting away from him in a big way. All right, man. We can't keep letting him catch us with these power punches. Plan A, Joe, but plan B is what he needs. Back him up. Remember, he wants to get in close. The jab is free. He's not going to be able to do a countering on the back. Ooh. Somebody was going down with those two punches that just got thrown. We both miss. I catch him with the uppercut. It's straight. Come on, keep throwing them hooks, baby. Let's go. Send his ass down, man. Let's go, baby. He might not get up from this one. This is a brutal fight, man. I'm loving it. It's a brawl. He gets up like and shit happens. So this dude definitely has a strong chin. I don't know how much longer he's going to last. Yes, sir. That was a cool. He felt that one. Oh, yeah. Double uppercuts. Come on. I'm definitely trying to send him to the canvas. This close. That one probably would have been it. But we're still winning this fight, man. So we just got a nice little strategy. We see how the dude fought the first few rounds. Real aggressive getting inside and stuff. Let him punch himself tired and eventually leave himself open. You gotta remember, we are a counterpuncher, so we don't have to be, you know, so aggressive.
Relax.
I wonder if there's an answer.
All right, you see us winning all but the one round that we got knocked down, and we won the last two rounds by two from both not getting knocked down. After round together. You know, that's the right question, Joe. We knocked him down twice last round. Not to the guy who's winning. He's gonna keep. See what I mean? He's gonna leave himself open. Double uppercut getting through the guard. Chill. There it is. Just gotta wait our opportunities. He's trying to get me in this corner. He's doing a good job of cutting the ring off. And like I said, just let him punch himself tired. Eventually, you're going to give me my opening.
Dismisses his opponent's headshot. Hill's offense has
nice little uppercut. You know, them things is deadly, too.
All
right, let's chill.
He was hurt earlier. He got
you see his health, man. He's definitely hurting a lot more than we are. He wants to clinch. He knows it. But he also, you see that punch. He knows he needs a knockout to win, man. And we can't give in to that.
That's the clean shot with the
way to get through the guard there.
He was looking for by Hill.
There it is, baby. That straight is a hell of a punch. Give him a hook on the way down. Say goodbye. Let's get it, man. He's lights out right there. But just to add more disrespect, go down. You're taking too long, bro. I'll really be disappointed in myself if he gets up. Wow. Somehow this dude is still standing. He's got a lot of heart. We got to be careful now that we don't get knocked out. Because remember, he's stunned us and he has power. But it's over. It's over. It's over, baby.
That's it. It's over. Fight is over. Hill's not going to hear from those judges. He's a knockout victim.
Ladies and gentlemen, by way of